we headed into Cartagena to buy some cameras.
Right, this Jeep Wrangler hardtail cost £8,000. And absolutely everything on it works. And with my Hercule Poirot hat on, I would say that this car was originally sold in Japan because the television CD sat-nav system here is all in Japanese, which means can't work it. And then you've got little stickers all over everywhere. This one says, look, hysteric glamour and CDC rockers. That's a very Japanesey thing to do. So this was built in Ohio, shipped to Japan, exported to England, and then I've shipped it to Colombia. This then has done 120,000 miles on the road, but about twice that on ships. I think it's going to be ideal, though, for wildlife photography because it's four-wheel drive, it's a Jeep, so I could use it to track a snow leopard. It's got a 4-litre straight six, so I could keep up with a diving eagle. And of course, no roof, fold-down windscreen, so a 360-degree field of fire, form a camera.
Let me fill you in a bit on my 1998 Chevy CK Silverado. It's a full-size American pickup that's been made a bit bigger with a lift kit and modifications that I'll tell you about later. Most importantly, it's got a proper big old 7.4-litre V8 up front in a very lazy state of tune, just churning out huge gobbets of grunt. I have four-wheel drive, high and low ratios. That and this massive lift kit, I can go anywhere. Probably most wildlife photographers use things like this anyway. You don't see it, you know, on the telly with Attenborough and stuff, because, well, this is behind the scenes. This is how they get there.
Now we're alone, viewers, let me tell you a little bit about my car. And I know some of you are thinking, oh, that's just a Fiat Panda, and they're in South America, they're bound to be going over difficult terrain, yes, yes, yes. But let me tell you this, what you need for serious off-roading is smallness and lightness. That's what I've got. This is a tiny car, it weighs 780 kilograms, a quarter of what Hammond's stupid monster truck weighs. It has a four-wheel drive system made in Austria, very dependable. Does have inclinometers on it so that I can see when I'm about to fall over. And it's perfect. It all works. The fan, the cooling system, all the instruments. It's all perfect.
Soon we arrived at the really rather beautiful walled city of Cartagena, which was bad news for the not at all beautiful Trump truck.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, hang on. Are these walls important and, like, really old and precious?
17th century, Hammond. That's how old they are. It's a World Heritage Site. A World Heritage Site.
Well, if they're that old, the old chip won't matter, will it?
What a moron.
Oh, my God.
If I lived in a walled World Heritage site, I wouldn't be pleased to see that coming in.
This is proper jungle now. Oh, hello. I'm in the British Railway tunnel. Oh, no, Hammond.
Oh, tunnel.
Stop it.
I had to do it. It's the law.
We drove for miles along the disused railway until eventually LGB Jeremy came to a halt.
Gentlemen, I'm rather confused here. We're approaching a bridge, okay? It says no cars, no people, no motorcycles, and no horses.
Well, what's it for, then?
Moments later, we found out. It's all right, James. Why don't you just... He is actually going. James doesn't like heights.
Oh, did you see that one just moved?
Yes. What is that? Hold on. That's one, two. You've got 7 or 8, maybe 8 feet.
But that means I'll have to drive. I can't.
Wait, it's got massive tyres. You'll just be running on the outer ones.
Well, so I get to this bit. My car is wider than that, and that's wider than my wheel. It won't do it.
And that's high, actually. What is that, 300 feet?
Some hundreds of feet, yes. Oh, dear.
Even though Hammond isn't at all accident-prone, I went first. Seatbelt on or off? Off. Because what bloody difference will it make? Really? God, there's a really, really narrow bit there. Ooh, speed? No. I don't think speed's the answer. Oh. Right, I've made it. That's good. Hammond, you will shit your pants doing this.
Well, that's helpful.
I already am watching.
Spider-Man May shot across as fast as he dared.
Not looking down, thinking about other things.
And then it was the turn of Big Donald.
Oh, God. I can do this by looking at the driver's side tyre and keeping it as close as I can to that edge and hoping to God that gives me enough. Oh, Christ. Oh, Jesus. I'm shaking all over. I can do this. I'm just going to look at the wood, not at what's below, just look at the wood. Ah! Oh. Jesus Christ, no, I'm too close to the edge. God! I think I might be sick. I will get there. Crossing this bridge is just part of my journey.
Is that clippity-clopping across my bridge?
Oh, God! Not the Billy Goat Grab game.
I will move my Jeep out of your way. If you can answer this simple prog rock question.
I don't know anything about prog rock at all!
Who is the bass guitarist in Barclay James Harvest?
The Nolan Sisters! Get me off this bridge! Let me off the bridge, I'm going to be sick, please.
Eventually, Hammond became quite irritated, so I abandoned the game. And soon, all of us became quite irritated.
Eventually, having fixed the Fiat, I was back on the road again.
This car is just amazing.
But then...
Oh dear, I think I've just lost the exhaust pipe.
As it turned out, the broken exhaust was lifting my mood too.
This is tremendous. It's like being on a rally stage.
I happen to know that Tony and Sherry Blair were in fact massive World Rally Championship fans. In fact, I think they took part in a couple on the quiet. They just didn't want people to know about it. They thought it was sort of damage their reputation and their standing.